Assalamu alaikum, I'm Hina Ijaz. Welcome to Pakistan. In fact, today I will be welcoming somebody to Lahore, somebody who has just come to Pakistan almost 4 months ago. He belongs to a country which has various ethnicities, be it Kazakhs, be it Uzbeks, and many more, also Russians. Well, they speak Russian and they also speak their own language, Kazakh. Well, I think I've spilled the beans here. I'm talking about His Excellency, Mr. Yerzhan Kistafin. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly, Ambassador for Kazakhstan to Pakistan. He, like I said, he's moved to Pakistan. It's been 4 months and our off-air discussion tells me that he is in love with Pakistan. He is having, he's having a pleasant time here. In fact, he also wants to tell Pakistanis that how beautiful and how great is Kazakhstan. And I would, on a personal level, to like to learn more about Kazakhstan, given it's a Central Asian country, former Soviet Republic. There's so much to learn, there's so much history. Let's not forget, Genghis Khan once ruled there as the head of the Mongol Empire. And we do see some influence there still. It may be prevalent in some areas. I'd like to find out more. And I'm not going to keep my other special guest waiting here. I'm talking about Brigadier Mansoor Syed Sheikh Sahab. Of course, Sitara Imtiaz bhi hai. Wo bhi inhe hasil, and wo bhi inko, he also had the privilege of receiving it. And that's because, of course, jo unki achievements hai, aaj us par bhi nazar dalenge. He's the Vice President in Punjab for Center for Global and Strategic Studies. Intense depth and knowledge here on this side, and here we get to know so much about Kazakhstan, and let's talk about Pakistan-Kazakhstan relations too, and there's so much to learn. Excellency, thank you for joining us today.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. You've come all the way from Islamabad, yeah. And I am going to specially give you a very warm welcome to Lahore. Lahore, I would like to find out, have you been to Lahore before?
This is my very first visit to Lahore, to a beautiful city, yes.
And right. The minute you stepped down from the motorway, how was that experience?
No, it's well known that Lahore is considered as a cultural capital of a
Absolutely.
Beautiful country. So I feel that, you know, it's a beautiful city and I see so many beautiful things. So we should, you know, increase awareness of our Kazakh community, and not only about Kazakhstan, but in general, awareness about the beauty of your country.
Absolutely.
And, sometimes, you know, the image that we see on the international arena has nothing in common with the modern face of beautiful Pakistan.
Absolutely, and we are keen on finding out more about Kazakhstan,
yeah, sure,
your country.
Sure.
Well, Brigadier Sahab, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Bilkul theek.
Well, good to have you.
Thank you very
well,
much.
Well, aap bhi bahut sare foreign assignments pe, you've been abroad, you've been
yes.
stationed there.
Yes.
Sitara Imtiaz ka bhi title aapke paas hai, kya nahi hai? To kya nahi kiya aapne zindagi mein, ye bhi bata dijiye.
Kya nahi kiya? Mera khayal hai sab kuch kar liya. Kuch aur karne ki koi abhi gunjaish nahi hai.
Right.
Sab kuch
well,
kar
I'm
liya.
Sure there must be something. I'm going to give you a chance to think. But in the meantime, मैं आपको दिखाऊंगी एक रिपोर्ट, रिपोर्ट दैट वी स्पेशली प्रिपेयर्ड ऑन कजाकिस्तान, ऑन दिस ब्यूटीफुल लैंड एंड इट्स ब्यूटीफुल पीपल. लेट्स गो टेक अ लुक एट इट एंड व्हेन वी रिटर्न वी कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन विद हिज एक्सलेंसी.
Thank you.
Kazakhstan extends from the Caspian Sea from the west, and its eastern border is shared with China and Russia. So much influence coming in from all these sides, so many different ethnicities residing there, living as one. So much to do there, beautiful museums showcasing different artifacts. How lovely and wonderful. As for a tourist, one is definitely recommended to go and visit Kazakhstan. On the other hand, it's the world's largest landlocked country, the ninth largest in the world.
Being landlocked,
what are the opportunities, or let's say what are the advantages and disadvantages in terms of trade for you?
You know, for centuries, our country served as a bridge connecting Europe with Asia, East with West. So I believe that such location, very, I would say, interesting and important geopolitical location, can serve us a lot in terms of developing cooperation between the countries of Eurasia. Moreover, I always say that even when it comes to cooperation between Kazakhstan and Pakistan, Kazakhstan can serve as a golden gate for Pakistan in terms of getting access to the Eurasian Economic Union nowadays. It's Russia, Belarus, Kyrgyzstan, and to the central, to the markets of the Central Asian region, of course. Moreover, we can serve as a golden gate in terms of getting access to the European Union. Let me give you just one example. Last year, we finalized construction of the railroad connecting the Western China with Europe. And now the delivery time takes about 14-15 days in comparison to the 30-40 days by sea. So again, we see that there are some great opportunities for our country to develop. But
yes,
at the same time, being the landlocked country, it's very important for us to have access to the warm waters. And
right,
in this term, Pakistan can serve as a golden gate for our country because you can provide us with the shortest route in terms of getting access to the open sea.
Are there any talks in initiation or in the pipeline regarding this?
Sure.
Are there?
Yeah. We have established the Joint Working Group on Transport and Regional Connectivity. Nowadays, regional connectivity is the name of the game.
Mm-hmm.
And we are very, you know, interested and keen in developing different transit routes between Kazakhstan and Pakistan. We can serve each other as regional hubs, and through partnership between our countries, we could significantly increase our transit and export potential.
In fact, Pakistan was one of the first countries to recognize Kazakhstan
exactly
as a state.
True.
When it gained independence in the year 91 in December. So you are relatively a very young country and have achieved a lot. You have a huge population base. So again, talking about the fact that being landlocked, Brigadier Saab, if you would like to also contribute in this discussion with the vast experience that you carry. Being landlocked and at the same time being the ninth largest country in the world, having a large population base, the relations between Pakistan and Pakistan and Kazakhstan have always remained stable. So what opportunities are we looking at here?
After the dismemberment of USSR, creation of the Central Asian Republics, and especially in the 21st century, this century, there are more opportunities, and Central Asian republics, they are opening up, they are looking at their economy, they are looking at their population. And
right,
as the ambassador very rightly said, this is the time and a great opportunity to bridge the gap between the countries and bridge the societies for their shared future.
Hmm.
So connectivity, regional connectivity is the name of the game today. And
right,
this is what is Pakistan trying to reach out to these countries and offering and coordinating various ways and terms and means to cooperate with each other to take advantage of this opportunity.
Right.
A great,
so the two-way trade factor, which you just mentioned, in fact, a few days ago, it was highlighted in the newspapers, that once relations and trade links, in fact, between Pakistan and Kazakhstan are improved, it would help, in fact, the entire region.
Exactly.
You emphasized on the phrase two-way trade.
Yes.
So when we talk about two-way, so are you looking more on the export side or the import side?
Both. The thing is that, you know, we consider Pakistan as a regional power. And Kazakhstan, as you might know, is a leader of Central Asia.
Absolutely.
So we believe that if we join our efforts, if we join our hands, it will be useful and beneficial, not only for our two countries, but for the whole region, including Afghanistan.
Yes.
Afghanistan can serve as a transit hub in terms of developing cooperation between Central Asia and Southern Asia. And just like you rightly mentioned, next year we will be celebrating 30th anniversary of establishment
yes.
of diplomatic
Congratulations
relations.
Congratulations in advance for
that. Yeah, between Kazakhstan and Pakistan. But when it comes to our history, we are talking only about our modern history. So we celebrate this year 30th anniversary of independence of our country. But if we go back to our history, our countries cooperated, our nations cooperated for centuries. So it's about reviving brotherly relations between Kazakhstan and Pakistan. It's something bigger and deeper.
So you are looking at Pakistan as a regional power, and also the secondary factor would be the large population.
Yes.
So population plays a huge role. So similarly, the Kazakhstan market is also attractive for Pakistanis when you talk about a two-way trade, because you also have a large population to an extent.
No, I don't think so. We have one of the lowest density population. We are only 19 million people, less than
Karachi. Yeah, that's our city population.
Yes, true.
So you are looking at the population factor, and we could look at you in terms of the route. Regionally,
yes,
right. So, you, in terms of what you've said in your last interview to a newspaper, you think bilateral trade could be one thing to look at. Right?
To be honest with you, nowadays our trade turnover is something, according to your statistics, I mean the Pakistani statistics, it's about $103 million. But according to our statistics, it's only $36 million. But you know, for such great countries as Kazakhstan and Pakistan, it's nothing.
Right.
There is a great room for strengthening, increasing our bilateral trade. We have so many things, you know, areas for bilateral cooperation, and it will be mutually beneficial. It's kind of win-win situation. It's not only about export or import, it's about both. So we can learn from each other, and we can help each other to develop our, you know, different sectors of our economies. For example, our president said that agriculture should be as another driver for economic development of Kazakhstan. And in this term, I believe it could be extremely useful for us to develop cooperation with Pakistan in agriculture.
Right.
Another very important industry is pharmaceutical industry.
Okay, looking at farmers.
Exactly. Our president said that we need to develop our pharmaceutical industry. And in this term, I believe, again, we could learn a lot from your industry. Your industry is, you know, one
that's
of the best in the world.
You.
So that's why I believe we should develop as many good direct communications between our business communities, you know, between Kazakhstan and Pakistan.
Time for a short break. Milte hain ek choti si break ke baad. Welcome back, and we're in conversation with Mr. Yashan, who is ambassador for Kazakhstan to Pakistan. Your president is also expected to visit Pakistan next
Inshallah,
year, is that
next
right?
Year. Yeah, you're right. He's planning to visit. He accepted kind invitation by the president of Pakistan, His Excellency Dr. Arif Alvi. And I hope that next year, maybe somewhere in, you know, next fall.
It's in the pipeline, it's being planned?
Yeah, yeah.
Excellent. That's excellent news. Yeah. So a fun fact, like always like giving a fun fact in this program. A fun fact right now is that His Excellency has also talked about the fact that there should be an exchange of TV programs between Kazakhstan and Pakistan that definitely allows both populations, both nations, the people of both these nations to understand each other's culture, tradition. That's a great way to connect. It's always a great medium to connect. We've done that with other countries, and that has certainly helped us to understand them and for them to understand us. So if we're able to do that with Kazakhstan, I believe not only bilateral trade, also tourism, that can also get a great pump.
Sure.
Is that right?
Yeah, I fully agree with you. And moreover, nowadays, the main challenge that I see is the lack of information.
Yes.
Our nations know little about each other. despite the fact that, you know, in the past we cooperated for centuries. So now we need to fill the gap.
Yes.
And when it comes to cooperation between Kazakhstan and Pakistan, you know, we have so many things in common. So this is the main idea, is to deliver this message to our communities. And the best way to reach out to our people is, you know, cooperation between our TV channels. Mm. And, you know, we could exchange TV programs, TV shows, showing the beauty of your nature, the beauty of our nature.
Absolutely.
Our traditions, our history, and our people will understand how close we are.
We have to educate one another.
Exactly,
about
exactly.
About ourselves.
Yes.
And Kazakhstan needs to educate themselves about to us.
Yeah.
And it's a two-way thing.
Yes.
So we need these exchange TV programs. That'll be very, very helpful.
It will boost our people to people. It would boost our B2B. It will boost everything.
Absolutely. That is what today's world is all about. Now, coming towards the economy, you've mentioned the pharmaceutical industry, you've mentioned agriculture and also education. So you're talking about the fact that there should be more joint ventures between private enterprises of your country and ours. So how is that going to happen?
So about 5 years ago, we have established the bilateral council, business council, between Kazakhstan and Pakistan. Now we need to reactivate this very important platform. It should be kind of, you know, universal platform for establishing B2B ties and exchanging information.
You mean to deactivate it, if I've heard.
Reactivate. Now it's deactivated. Now we need to reactivate.
So it's our deactivated. Bilateral. You need to start the car again. Is that right?
So the very first step is to, you know, to start a dialogue between our people, between our business communities, and then I'm pretty sure that, you know, it will boost our bilateral trade. You know, your market is huge. It's more than 225 million people, so I'm pretty sure that your market will be extremely attractive for our country, and vice versa, our market will be attractive for your business people in terms of developing our pharmaceutical industry, our agriculture, so on and so forth.
Mr. Rajan, you seem very excited with all your goals that you've set in. It's been 4 months that you've arrived in Pakistan. You seem very excited about what you plan to do with Pakistan. You are on a good mission, appears to be. What goals do you think we'd be able to achieve by next year when it comes to especially bilateral trade between the two nations?
The first thing that we have to address is to resume direct flights. The main issue that we have today is the absence of direct air communication between our countries. Without direct flights, it will be extremely difficult to boost our people-to-people or B2B. So we need to resume finally flights between Kazakhstan and Pakistan. Another thing that we need, as I mentioned, to reactivate our bilateral business council and to organize as many events for our business community. I would say sector-specific webinars, roundtables dedicated to developing cooperation in the pharmaceutical industry, in agriculture, you know, in other sectors that could be mutually beneficial.
Right.
These are the main points for us. And next year, for example, I can tell you that in March, we are planning to organize an exhibition made in Pakistan.
That's excellent news.
In Almaty. Moreover, on November 24th, 25th, we are planning to organize a two-day business forum in our southern capital, in Almaty.
So traders, businessmen, entrepreneurs from Pakistan will be able to exhibit their goods and products under one roof in Kazakhstan. Is that right?
Yeah.
So next year, you're planning that?
Yes.
I think that's very good news. And then you also spoke about the fact in one of your interviews that, that of course, which is a fact also, that Kazakhstan is the largest economy in Central Asia. You have huge oil and gas reserves.
Yeah.
So how can one look at the trade factor when we specifically try and focus on this sector?
Yeah, you see, again, last year it was agreed to establish three working groups. The first one on trade and investment, the second one on transport and regional connectivity, and the third one on our cooperation in energy. So we are planning, inshallah, to organize our joint working group, the very first session online, in this month. And we will, the main idea of this joint working group is to identify the possible ways for developing cooperation in energy. Right. We know that there is a growing demand in yes. Pakistan in terms of energy, and Kazakhstan is blessed by Allah, you know, with huge reserves of oil, gas, and you know, other natural resources. So we are ready
you know
to cooperate
what
in this
Urdu
field.
When you say that, yeah. Mashallah.
Mashallah, yes.
I mean in Arabic, not in Urdu. Yeah. Mashallah, and you've been blessed.
Yeah.
That's a blessing. Yeah. So, I also want our audience to understand a little bit about the culture of Kazakhstan. We've talked a lot about how we're going to improve our trade relations with Kazakhstan, and we really look forward to that. And we especially would really like to welcome the president of Kazakhstan, his visit next year, hopefully, inshallah, as
inshallah.
I may say.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, we would love that to happen. And the way Pakistan has supported Kazakhstan, always recognized it, as I said, in December 91 when it was made independent. And the way Kazakhstan has stood by Pakistan always. We hope this friendship continues and brings out more positive things. So the culture, tell us more about it.
About culture, you know, again, we are so close to each other. Our cultures, you know, to some extent are very similar. That's why we are planning to organize a number of events
right.
in Pakistan.
Cultural events.
Cultural events.
That'll be great.
Moreover, yesterday when I met with the governor of Punjab province, we discussed ways for twinning our spiritual centers, Lahore and in our case, Turkestan.
Right.
We consider Turkestan as a cradle of nomadic Turkic civilization. And Lahore is considered as a, you know, spiritual capital of your great country. So I believe it would be extremely interesting and useful to, you know, to establish sister cities between our two spiritual capitals. And we could work on developing our cultural ties. And I believe that the regional level of our cooperation is another very important pillar that we should be focused on. And I'm pretty sure that, you know, by the end of this year, we will have some good news.
Excellent. I'm waiting for that good news. However, coming to ease of obtaining a visa for your yeah. country, now that for many people, once they're planning to go to a certain country as a tourist, getting, obtaining the visa, the requirements, eligibility factor. So what ease are you going to provide to Pakistanis and Kazakhstan, the Kazakhs who are planning to come to Pakistan? What talks have you had with the Pakistani officials regarding this to have an easy access to obtain a visa for Pakistan, for Kazakhs?
So nowadays, our people, I mean Kazakh citizens, if they are willing to visit your beautiful country, they just need to apply online.
Right, it's easy
and it's
now,
about
right?
3 or 5 days maximum.
Wonderful.
To get, you know, your I mean, Pakistani visa. In our case, we have more traditional way, I would say, mm-hmm. but I'm working with our government, and I believe that we need to facilitate the visa regime for our Pakistani friends and brothers, and I'm trying to implement this on gradual, you know, approach, step by step. So my main focus today is officials and business communities. Because if we want to boost our B2B cooperation, we should facilitate our visa
regime. Absolutely,
regions.
That's one
it's
of the
essential.
Most important things
it's
to do.
Fully
because more Pakistanis need to visit Kazakhstan and Kazakhs need to come to Pakistan. Yeah. Having such friendly relations with a great country as great as Kazakhstan, one needs to definitely visit it. Because it's just not, we're not encouraging this because the two nations have been friendly throughout these years, these decades. But there's so much to see in Kazakhstan. If you just Google it, I'm sure you'd be inclined to visit. You'd be more motivated to visit the place. So do that. And the ease of applying for a visa, Mr. Yerjan has said he is definitely working on that. And for Kazakhs to come to Pakistan, whereas we've made the process quite simple, 3 to 4 days.
Yeah,
so
true.
I'm sure, Mr. Yerjan, I'd really like to convey this on air in front of our audience to you that the efforts that you're putting in for the betterment of relations, for strengthening trade ties between the two nations, coming up with innovative ideas, that's giving us a lot of hope that there's so much in store in Rome for Kazakhstan and Pakistan together. as these two nations coming together and creating something great for the region, beneficial for the region. So I'm going to wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
And we hope that once you come to Lahore again, we have you on the show again, and once the president is here, we have an opportunity to meet him as well.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
So much for your time.
My pleasure.
And I'm just going to say goodbye to you by saying safe journey.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Time for a short break. Milte hain ek choti si break ke baad. Well, we had His Excellency, Mr. Irjan, Ambassador for Kazakhstan to Pakistan shortly, right before this break. We had him and we had to say goodbye to him. He had a long journey to cover. He had to be back in another city. So we talked about the significance of Kazakhstan and Pakistan's relations. As Kazakhstan is the largest economy in Central Asia, and Pakistan and Kazakhstan having better trade ties could mean better economies for both nations. Coming back to my next guest, as I introduced him before, Brigadier Mansoor Saeed Sheikh Saab, Tamga Imtiaz bhi award hua hai ne, aur foreign inko assignments bhi mile. 35 years he served in the Pakistan Army. He served on external borders as a diplomat and achieved valuable experience through extensive travels abroad. He has been there, done that, done a lot. What is he doing right now? All right, I'll fill you in. I'll repeat that. I did tell you about it at the start of the show. However, I'm going to repeat that for your memory. Brigadier Saab is also Vice President in the Punjab region for Center for Global and Strategic Studies. Now, what does this center exactly do? It's doing a great job. It's doing a great service to the nation. In fact, well, Brigadier Saab has served the nation for 35 years, but once an army man, always an army man, and he hasn't forgotten his task, and therefore he's a part of this center. Ji, Brigadier Saab, aap kaise serve kar rahe hain aap nation ko through this center?
Serve the nation is tarike se ke Center for Global and Strategic Studies, CGSS we call it. It's a think tank, public policy institute. Basically, we formulate policy and try to help the decision makers and policy makers through research and analysis. So, इसके लिए हमारे पास हमने माशाल्लाह बहुत सारे पाकिस्तान के टॉप के हर सोसाइटी के हर वॉक ऑफ लाइफ के टॉप जो लोग हैं वो हमारे एडवाइजरी बोर्ड पर.
अगर आप अपने एडवाइजरी बोर्ड से हमें थोड़ा मुतारिफ करें.
जी, एडवाइजरी बोर्ड हमारा उसमें रिटायर्ड ब्यूरोक्रेट्स हैं, आर्मी और सीनियर आर्मी ऑफिसर्स हैं, जजेस हैं, वकला हजरात हैं, सीनियर नाम लाइक एतराज हसन लाइक मैनी अदर्स वो हैं, बिजनेस कम्युनिटी के लोग हैं, डिफरेंट वॉक ऑफ लाइफ डॉक्टर्स हैं. So we have these people on our advisory board, and relevant to the kind of project that we have on hand, we invite them.
It's basically a think tank, and you are giving advice to, let's say, the right circles.
Yes. We work with the
government. To decision makers, to policy makers.
To policy makers at the federal government level.
Right.
And in the private sector also to the chief executive officers and the business community people.
Right.
Like we did one for Faisalabad, the textile industry.
Achha.
Yeah. Usme ek project
pe kaam kiya. Wo bhi aapko
approach karte. Aur isi tarike se Hyderabad mein hume locust ke hawale se there was a study that we had to carry out. So, wo humne ki. So, we are doing into various, but lately, of late, we are concentrating more on regional connectivity. That is Central Asian states, Eurasian countries. So, we are interacting more. So, As you heard the guest with you today,
yes,
on our invitation, he had come to Lahore from Islamabad, and today we took him in the morning to Punjab University.
अभी तक कितने ambassadors आप लेकर आ चुके हैं लाहौर?
For because of COVID, we could not
naturally.
I mean that was एक but अभी तक हम तकरीबन 5-6 एम्बेसडर्स को
That's a big number.
ला चुके हैं.
That's a big number.
Almost all the ambassadors they want to come. Basically, पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी में हमने पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी से मिलके एक रीजनल इंटेग्रेशन सेंटर तैयार करवाया है, बनवाया है. ठीक है, इट इज़ गवर्नमेंट अप्रूव्ड. सो पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी के एक यू कैन से इट्स अ डिपार्टमेंट विद इन पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी, रीजनल इंटेग्रेशन सेंटर.
राइट.
So all these regional countries, we bring the ambassadors to them. They talk to the students. They talk, interact with the faculty members. They,
right.
You see, we thought that bringing the students and academia, professors, teachers of two countries, any two countries together, to interact, exchange programs,
ideas. It's like bringing the intelligentsia together.
Together. So again, bringing the academia into the policy making of any country.
Excellent. So ये आते हैं, आप इनका interaction कराते हैं इन लोगों से, और उसके बाद नए ideas generate हो रहे हैं. ये बताइए कि जितने 5-6 ambassadors आए हैं, इनका क्या view point रहा है जब ये खास इस्लामाबाद से लाहौर आ रहे हैं? एक cultural change भी है, एक माहौल का भी change है, सोच का भी चेंज है, इन अ पॉजिटिव वे आई एम सेइंग. क्या इनका राय या रद्द अमल लेके वापस जा रहे हैं?
आई थिंक ये एम्बेसडर खास तौर पे जो सेंट्रल एशियन एम्बेसडर्स हैं ना, ये तो अब लाहौर को अपना सेकंड होम समझते हैं.
बहुत अच्छी खबर है.
रियली रियली, बिकॉज इट्स अगर मैं आपको ये बताऊं कि 1500 BC
जी
से हमारे ताल्लुकात हैं.
वो तो है,
है ना?
लेकिन तो खुश हो रहे हैं वो लाहौर शहर को देख के, आप ये कह रहे हैं?
नहीं नहीं, वैसे भी ताल्लुकात तो हमारे, देखे अगर हमारा डीएनए भी चेक करवाए तो मे भी इधर
कहीं ना कहीं से इधर उधर कहीं
निकल आएगा. तो हमारी जीन्स तो इधर है.
बिल्कुल.
सो वी हैव टू, आई मीन दैट इज मे बी अट्रैक्टिंग.
मे बी it does play a role.
It does play a role.
Yes. So we're getting into a very deep scientific discussion.
Yes.
But it does make a lot of sense.
Yes. So I think jitne ambassador aur jinke sath hum Islamabad mein bhi interact karte hain, abhi Lahore nahi aaye ya aayenge,
yes,
so you will find ke they are all very positive, really impressed, and they are also impressed by the progress made, especially in a few field like pharmaceutical, like leather goods, leather
industry. He's mentioned education, agriculture and pharmaceutical. ये खास तीन industries हैं जिनमें हमारी industries इसमें ये interested हैं.
ये interested हैं.
और oil and gas की जहाँ पे बात हो रही है reserves, वो इनके पास बेताहाश हैं.
वो हम interested.
और ये two way trade जो है इस तरह चल सकती है.
और उसमें सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि ये चूंकि landlocked हैं सारे. इनकी ओपनिंग अब इनको थ्रू सी पैक एंड आफ्टर अफगानिस्तान का पीस इन टू अफगानिस्तान वो इनको दिखाई दे रही है. सो एज ही सेड के हॉट वाटर्स, सो दे वांट टू रीच हॉट वाटर्स फॉर देयर ट्रेड. तो इसलिए पाकिस्तान में उन्होंने, पाकिस्तान में भी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान और पाकिस्तान में पॉलिसी मेकर और इवन प्राइवेट सेक्टर में इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, they must think how to make utilize the them in our own favor.
Absolutely, absolutely. Brigadier sahab, there's so much to do in this area. Main to aapko recommend karungi ki aap ye hamare show ka hissa constant bane rahe, aur hame har ek jo bhi aap ambassador lahore lekar aa rahe hain उनकी फीडबैक, उनके जो वो काम उन्होंने या ऑब्जेक्टिव्स अपने एजेंडा जो सेट किया है उसको ज़रूर शेयर करें, क्योंकि ये आम आवाम भी सुन के इस चीज़ को खुश होगी, जान पाएगी कि पाकिस्तान किस सिम्त में चल रहा है, किस तरह तरक्की हो रही है, क्या प्लान किया जा रहा है. हम बहुत दफ़ा देखते हैं कि इंटरनेशनल ग्लोबल ट्रेड की बात करते हैं और हमेशा होती है उस पर है, बहुत अच्छी बात है, होनी चाहिए, लेकिन आपके इर्द गिर्द जो भाई हैं, ये मूल ममालिक हैं, इनको ज़रूर देखें और इनकी रीजनल इम्पोर्टेंस हमारे लिए देखें और हमारी उनके लिए। देयर इज़ अ लॉट ऑफ म्यूचुअल इंटरेस्ट एंड बेनिफिट दैट कैन बी अटेन्ड, जो आज के शो में आप ज़रूर देख पाए होंगे। जब आपने एम्बेसडर फॉर कजाकिस्तान टू पाकिस्तान मिस्टर यजान को देखा, उनकी बातें सुनी, कितना स्कोप है, कितना पोटेंशियल है, कितनी अपॉर्चुनिटी है, डू नॉट इग्नोर दैट। ये आज आप सीख पाए हैं एंड आपकी वजह से हम इंशाल्लाह फ्यूचर में भी आई एम श्योर ये सब जान पाएंगे। ब्रिगेडियर साहब, वक्त ही कमी है, वरना मजीद इस पर बात करते। आज हम कजाकिस्तान पर लिमिटेड थे, बट इन द कमिंग प्रोग्राम्स, इन द कमिंग एपिसोड्स, वी प्रॉमिस वी ब्रिंग टू यू more on what's happening within the region, what kind of trade ties are we forming, setting in, planning, initiating. Thank you, Brigadier Saab, once again wish you Thank all you the best with your Center for Global and Strategic Studies. What a wonderful forum you've created.
Thank you.
Aur aapse main ijazat lungi, I'll be seeing you here next week same time. Keep watching Discover Pakistan.